I knew it wouldn't be too long before you ended up in this place.
They never would have got me if I hadn't wanted to come back.
You. Doreen.
I only came back so as I could see you. It's your fault Frankie's dead. She never would have got out and been dead by now if it hadn't been for you.
Doreen, that's not true.
You killed her!
Stop this.
How did this happen?
Bumped into a door. Ask Miss Bennett.
Yes, a door with a right hook.
Believe what you want.
I hear Doreen Anderson is back.
She certainly is.
Gave herself up at the gate.
She didn't stand a chance without Doyle. At least she had brains enough to realize that. Anyway, there were certain people she couldn't wait to see again.
What do you mean?
Ask Travers. She'll be moved to her old cell shortly. I think she's really looking forward to that, don't you, Travers?
You're the one who's looking forward to it.
Did Doreen do that?
Ask your patient, Doctor.
I see.
We're dealing with animals in here. They're bound to draw blood occasionally. Nothing much we can do about it.
You could have her moved to another cell.
I don't see the point. These things happen.
Did you report this to the governor?
Are you trying to tell me my job, Doctor?
Yeah, I think you know exactly what you're doing, Miss Bennett.
Catherine, we've got to discuss it. I mean, you can't just sit there and pretend it's all a bad dream.
Isn't it?
We have to think seriously about what Mr. Wilson said, about your plea.
I do wish you hadn't sent Sarah to stay with your sister.
Oh, look, she and Viv get along just fine. We have to talk.
She didn't want to go.
But it's better for her not to have to hear all this.
Well, better for her not to be with her emotionally unstable mother. I expect that's what you mean.
Oh, look, you know it's not like that, Catherine. Oh, blast. Now, who's that?
Oh, if it's Mrs. Pringle, tell her I'll take the tickets to the club tomorrow. I don't want to see her now. I should phone Di McMillan. She'll be expecting a call about that committee.
Yes?
Mr. Roberts?
That's right.
I'm Mrs. Warren, Bert Warren's wife.
Oh, look, I don't know if this is quite the problem.
I've got something to say. Let me in, please.
Catherine, Mrs. Warren.
I heard.
I won't sit down. I'm not staying long.
What do you want?
To see what sort of people you are.
Well, now you've seen us, you can leave.
Not before I've said what I've come to say, Mrs. Roberts.
Mrs. Warren, I think perhaps you'd better go.
I've got something to say and you're going to listen. My husband worked for you for 8 years. He was a decent, hard-working man. You know as well as I do. He didn't lay a hand on your daughter.
Look, Mrs. Warren, I'm as sorry as you are over what happened, but I don't think there's any point...
My husband's dead. What do you know about sorry?
Please, Mrs. Warren.
People who know Bert... I know he couldn't do a thing like that. Your wife must be mad, and your daughter too, to do what they've done.
I think you've said enough. Please go.
And then what? What happens to me? All my life, my husband worked for somebody else. He made money for people like your husband. All he ever took home was his salary. And now, because of you, I've got no one. Nothing. You can say you're sorry, but that doesn't help me. Just tell me what I'm expected to do now, on my own.
Look, this might not be the best time to discuss all this sort of thing, but perhaps tomorrow? Sorry.
If you see this woman again, it must be in front of our lawyer.
I don't have anything to do with lawyers.
Well, it's either that, or you don't speak to him at all. Ken?
Yes, perhaps that might be best.
All right. When?
I'll ring you this evening. I've got your number.
Oh, I'm sure you have.
The consulate was the focal point of the protest, but the 250 police on duty made sure that the marchers kept moving.
What happened to you? Doreen. Doreen punched you in the eye. Oh, I don't believe it.
You don't have to take my word for it. Vera's moving her into our cell.
You'll have a ringside seat.
No, don't worry. I don't intend to let any fighting interrupt my beauty sleep. Ooh, Frankie must have taught her some bad habits. We'll have to rehabilitate
her. Quiet! Listen.
Was committed for trial on a charge of murder today. She is Mrs. Catherine Roberts. Police say that Mrs. Roberts claimed the man raped her daughter. The dead man, Mr. Albert Warren, was crossing the road outside a milk bar when he was run down. He died shortly after being admitted to hospital. She is due...
Well, good on her.
You remember her, B? Real upper crust, looking for the silver at tea time.
Yeah, I remember her. Afraid of her own shadow. Just goes to show you, you can't judge a book by its cover. Even our Doreen's turning into a tiger.
I want Doreen Anderson moved to another cell. Put her in with Lizzie Birdsworth.
Very well.
I'm told she attacked Karen Travers, and there's every likelihood it could happen again. I don't want them together. I
suppose you've been talking to Dr. Miller.
How do you know that?
I took Travers to surgery.
Did you witness the attack?
Oh, I'd hardly call it an attack. It was a scuffle, nothing to worry about.
That is for me to decide. You are aware of the regulations. Why didn't you report it?
I didn't think it was important. If I came to you every time one of the women took a swipe at someone, I wouldn't have time to perform my duties.
May I remind you, Miss Bennett, that reporting such things to me is one of your duties.
It was a minor incident.
There is nothing minor about prisoners striking each other. I will not tolerate violence in this prison, and I will not have my officers tolerating it either.
I didn't just stand there. I broke it up as soon as it began.
Then it was unwise of you not to report it. I trust you'll be more diligent in the future. It is not the responsibility of the prison doctor to come to me with such things.
No, it's not. No doubt he has his reasons.
Oh, we're not going to have the pleasure of your smiling face, then, are we?
Oh, go bite your bum.
Hey, Doreen, there's something wrong with your mouth. You better keep it shut or your teeth might drop out.
Shut up, Smith. She's moving in with Birdsworth. Governor's orders.
Yes, yeah, someone's been talking.
I didn't say anything.
You don't need to. Not when you've got a nice friend like Dr. Miller. He'd hate to see anything happen to the lovely Mrs. Travers.
You needn't think me moving out's going to get you off the hook.
Smith, Travers, find something to do or I'll find something for you. Anderson, whatever you have in mind, forget it. You're in enough trouble as it is. I don't care what grievances you may imagine you have, there will be no fighting with other prisoners. Do I make myself clear?
Yeah.
Now that you are back here, you will obey the rules just like everyone else or suffer the consequences.
What are you going to do, slap me on the wrist?
You've been warned. Take her to her cell, Miss Bennett.
Birdsworth, Anderson's moving in with you. I'm sure you'll have lots to talk about.
Oh, Doreen, I'm glad to see you back again, if you know what I mean.
Big deal.
Well, it wasn't the same without you here.
Missed me, did you?
Yeah, I reckon I did.
Well, I didn't miss you.
Oh. Had a good time on the outside, did you?
Yeah.
I was sorry to hear about Frankie.
Shut up about Frankie. None of you are sorry about anything.
Doreen... This is Margaret.
What are you knitting? Bag to go over your head?
Leave her alone. She's not all there.
Don't you tell me what to do. I'll say what I like.
Oh, gone all tough while we were on the outside, have we?
Yeah, you better believe it.
Not so tough that you didn't come back.
I got me reasons.
Cut it out, Doreen. I've known you too long. You can drop the act. You can't kid me.
I'll drop you if you don't watch yourself. Just because I was your friend once doesn't make any difference. I don't need you. I don't need anybody. So keep away from me, both of you.
Would you like a cup of coffee? What did I just say?
Suit yourself.
Three sugars.
What's happened?
One of the women hit me.
Why?
Why not? This is a prison, not a girl guide camp.
Right. Well, let's hope it's not too long before you're out of here.
Yes, you seem to keep saying that. What are you doing here at this hour of the morning?
It's the only time I've got. Lynn Warner's trial comes up soon, and I'm defending a woman who ran down a man for raping her daughter. So, I've got a pretty full plate.
Everybody seems to be getting something done around here but me, by the sound of things.
I've already put your reasons for wanting a retrial before the Supreme Court. Now, we just have to be patient.
So you keep telling me.
There's a couple of few things here that I want you to sign, and I've got to go, I'm afraid. Hey, come on. Just keep the faith a little longer, huh?
Don't have much choice, do I?
I want you out of here. You know that.
Tell me what I'm signing.
What have I done now?
Wait till you're spoken to, Birdsworth.
Lizzie, I've had a phone call from a Dr. Craw about your brother Angus.
Angus?
He asked the doctor to contact you.
What's the matter with him?
It's bad news, I'm afraid. He's dying.
Oh.
He wants to see you.
Does he just?
I understand he's your only surviving relative. If you like, it could be arranged.
Bugger him.
What's your language?
He never did a damn thing for me. He never wrote once in all these years. Even before that, he couldn't have a bar of me, not unless he wanted something. I lent him 50 quid once, and I never got that back. All he ever cared about was horses.
Well, Lizzie, that may be so, but perhaps he wants to make his peace with you.
Nah, he's up to something. He never was any good.
Then you don't want to see him?
He could have been dead these past 50 years for all the brother he's been to me.
Well, I hope you won't regret it in the future.
I've been in here too long for that, Mrs. Davidson. Can I go now?
Yes.
He says he's very busy at the moment. Got a play for
him. Oh, did you tell him you had a bucket full?
He's going to represent that woman we saw on the news last night.
What, the one that ran that bloke down? Oh, we can look forward to seeing her in here too then. Oh, joke, Joyce.
I'm not in the mood.
Oh, come on, love. Now, don't let it get you down. And don't start counting the days, either. You'll go crackers. Everything happens in its own sweet time.
She'll have to plead insanity, I suppose.
Who? Oh, her. Insanity? Well, there's nothing insane in what she did. If I'd got my hands on the blokes that got my daughter hooked on drugs, the streets would have been piled high.
That's what she'll have to plead, though. Otherwise, she won't stand a chance.
Well, if I was in the jury, I wouldn't believe her. Everyone who kills someone these days says they were crazy at the time. As if you can be foaming at the mouth 1 minute and all right the next.
It happens.
Oh, look, either you're loony or you're not. You can't have it both ways. Well, you knew what you were doing, didn't you?
It's not that simple.
Well, well, the shearer's pin up. Hey, what did Davidson want?
She reckons me brother's dying. I didn't even know he was alive.
Hey, they're letting you out to see him?
Can if I want to.
When are you going to go?
I'm not. I don't want to see him.
What do you mean you don't want to?
He's always a proper bastard to me. He can hold somebody else's hand.
Oh, now, come on, that's not the point. Use your head.
How long have you been inside? Oh, years.
And have you ever had a day out?
Only with Doreen and Frankie.
Yeah, and what'd you do then? Climb over the fence and have a heart attack doing that?
It was worth it.
Now, come on, now, don't be stupid. Doesn't matter how you feel about your brother. This is probably your last chance to have a good look around outside. You'd be a bloody fool to turn it down. Next time you leave here, they'll be carrying you out. And you can bring a whole lot of prizzies back for your friends.
Oh, yeah? So that's the real reason you're interested in me having a day out.
Listen, you stupid cow. When my daughter died, they wouldn't even let me out to go to her funeral. Now they're offering you a day out on a plate to see someone you don't even give a damn about. And you reckon you're not going to go? Well, I'm telling you, if you don't go, I'll break your bloody neck.
Why this sudden change of heart?
Well, I've been thinking it over real careful, Mrs. Davidson, and I reckon I was a bit hasty, what with the shock and everything. After all, he is my brother. And I reckon if it's his last request, I should be big enough to forget our past differences and go to the poor old bloke if he's calling for me. I'm not getting any younger myself, and he's the only family I've got left, so I thought if he needs me, I should do what you say and go to him.
and make our peace.
I'm glad. I think you've made the right decision. I'm sure you won't regret it.
No. But how am I going to get to him? I mean, who's going to take me?
I'll take him, Mrs. Davidson.
Oh, I couldn't go with you. Not in that uniform. People would stare at me. They'd think I was a criminal.
Don't be stupid. You are a criminal.
Thank you, Miss Bennett, but I think I'll take Lizzie to see her brother.
If you want to accept the responsibility, don't forget she tried to escape with Doyle and Anderson. It's my opinion she doesn't deserve this privilege.
I'll be the judge of that.
I won't give you any trouble, Mrs. Davidson, I promise.
If you like, you may wear your own clothes.
Yeah? Wear my own clothes? Oh, I reckon they're old enough to be back in fashion.
Mrs. Warren, this is Mr. Wilson, my wife's lawyer.
How do you do?
Good. Sit down. My wife won't be with us, Mrs. Warren. We thought it might be better that way.
Mrs. Warren, I won't waste your time or ours by beating around the bush. Now, I understand from Mr. Roberts you paid a visit on him last night, and to put it bluntly, demanded money from him.
I didn't demand anything. I went to talk.
Mm-hmm. About money.
My husband worked for Mr. Roberts for 8 years. I appeal to whatever feelings of decency he might have, considering how Bert died. I feel I'm owed something for what I'm going through. I'm alone now. I'm just not going to shut myself away and be quiet about it.
Blackmail is a serious offense, Mrs. Warren.
Don't use that tone of voice to me. I'm not blackmailing anyone.
Well, I could prove otherwise if you continue with this.
You can't take away a man's life and give nothing in return.
Mrs. Warren, if there is any compensation due to you, then the courts will decide it. Until then, you won't receive as much as a penny from Mr. Roberts. Now, I hope I make myself clear.
You haven't any conscience at all, have you? You said last night you were sorry, but you don't give a damn. I hope your wife burns in hell for what she's done to me.
Well, she's a crafty one. Grief-stricken 1 minute. Not for every penny she can get the next.
I think she knows what she's doing.
Oh, I wouldn't bet on it.
Couldn't we have done something for her?
Mr. Roberts, I've already explained to you, your wife is on trial for murder. Ah, just think of how it would look if we paid the dead man's wife money.
I suppose you're right.
She'll be a witness for the prosecution, and they'd crucify us. I know you feel a certain responsibility, but you think about your wife. She is the one you should be worrying about. No one else.
Right, how are you going, Di? Great. Okay. Very good. Good girl, you finished already.
Last one to get it right's a rotten egghead.
Oh, leave them alone, Doreen. Can't you see they're trying to learn something?
Well, they're wasting their time then, aren't they?
Has everyone finished the first one?
Yeah.
That's not right.
Well, you'd know.
Teacher will be cross, dummy.
Just ignore her, Di.
Hey, Mrs. Travers, this one's been cheating. What are you going to do about it? Keep her in after school?
Rack off, Doreen.
I wasn't talking to you, dopey. What are you? Teacher's pet? Well, you can go without your play lunch. Hey, Mrs. Travers, what about teaching them some history?
Get out.
Make me.
I'll make you.
Don't
scam. God! You fail. Like I go to the top of the class.
Now, I don't want to see you back in here again tomorrow. There's nothing wrong with you. Really?
You heard the doctor.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
You'll be pleased to know that Anderson and Travers have been separated.
Huh?
Yes, the governor insisted on it. After you'd been to see her.
I merely expressed an opinion. I'm concerned for the health of the prisoners.
I think you should confine yourself to medical opinions. Their accommodation and general welfare is the concern of prison officers.
If the women are going to assault each other, then I consider it my business. I'm the one who has to take care of them.
Then treat them and leave the rest to us.
You weren't going to do a thing.
That's my prerogative.
Is it?
You do your job, Doctor, and I'll do mine. Just don't meddle in things that don't concern you. come down to earth yet.
Drop off.
What's my name?
B.
Will you remember that much?
Of course I remember.
I thought you might have forgotten who ran this place while you were on the outside.
No.
Then start acting like it. You might be up to bouncing little die around the floor and shooting your mouth off to impress the new girls, but none of that washes with me, Doreen. All right?
All right.
And I won't remind you again.
I told the governor I'd go, and guess who's going with me?
Who?
She is.
Yeah?
Yeah. And I can wear my own clothes.
You're looking right glam.
Why?
Well, bustles are out of fashion. This is the 20th century. But you wouldn't know that.
Well, not that old.
Anyway, I reckon it's a great honour to be going out with the governor in person.
You would, you dumb old mole.
Well, it is.
Of course it is. Isn't it, Doreen?
What's the matter with her, B? What's she trying to prove?
I don't know. But she's going to find herself in a heap of trouble if she doesn't wake up to herself.
Do you like a drink?
No.
Well, don't worry. I'm not turning into an alcoholic. Even your mother says there's nothing wrong with a sherry.
All right, I didn't say anything.
Get you some lunch.
Catherine, have you given any thought to your plea?
Yes. I'm not going to plead insanity.
Temporary insanity. There is a difference.
If there is, I can't see it.
Oh, darling, you've got to give yourself a chance.
I am not mad. I'm not going to have people thinking I'm some sort of nut that's got to be locked up in a padded room.
Who cares what people think? I don't want to lose you. What about Sarah?
I was thinking of Sarah when I did what I did. I was trying to protect her, and now they want to lock me away. Oh, don't look at me like that. Do you think I'm some sort of maniac, too?
We've got to prove that you're not some sort of cold-blooded murderer.
What happened with Mrs. Warren?
Wilson decided we shouldn't pay her a cent. It would only damage your case.
You're not seriously thinking of paying her, are you?
Oh, look, I don't know what I was thinking.
She bursts into our home and she says the filthiest things.
Please,
and then...
Catherine, I don't want to talk about it. She won't come near us anymore, all right?
Where did you get the money for my bail?
You don't have to worry about that.
No, where? Where? I want to know.
Well, I arranged to increase my overdraft.
And how are we going to pay Mr. Wilson?
He'll put in his account when it's all over. You don't have to worry about that now.
We're going to have to sell the beach cottage, aren't we?
Well, I don't know. Possibly. Nobody has enough ready cash for this sort of thing.
This won't affect Sarah, will it? Her school fees?
Oh, of course not. Look, it's not as if we were penniless. We'll just have to juggle a few things, that's all. Don't get upset. There's nothing to worry about.
I got this letter from my dad, and you said if I ever wanted to talk about anything...
Sure. What's the problem?
Well, I don't know. It's not awful or anything. Just a bit strange.
Would you like me to read the letter?
Thanks. He never was much for writing. Says they never come out the way he wants. Mum's the one who writes to everyone. He's got a nice hand, though. That's what Mum says. She gets him to write on the Christmas cards.
Well, he says here he's coming to see you. Well, that's good news, isn't it?
I suppose so.
Oh, why aren't you sure? Is he usually more affectionate in his letters?
No, like I said, he doesn't normally write. Mum does that. He just seems so distant.
Well, how do you think he felt when you and Doug left home like that?
I suppose he was angry. He didn't ever like Doug. Didn't trust him. Dad didn't really know Doug that well. Not like I did.
Do you think he could have felt a little bit hurt?
I hadn't really thought about it.
Do you love your father?
Oh, Always. When I was a kid, I used to brag about how he was the best daddy in the whole world.
And do you think he knows that? I mean, after all, you just did leave home without even saying goodbye.
Well, I wrote them a note.
It's hardly the same, is it? What do you think he means by a few problems?
I don't know. Me, I suppose.
Oh. There you go again, feeling sorry for yourself. The question is, what are you going to do about it?
Well, I suppose when he comes, if he comes, that is, I'll just have to try and let him know that I really am very sorry for all the trouble I've caused him, and not just for myself. Thanks.
You two wouldn't last 5 minutes outside on the run. You've got to think fast, keep one step ahead of yourself, and you can't relax for a minute.
Bet you slept with one eye open all the time.
Who said anything about sleep? Close your eyes and you're gone.
You must have slept sometime.
Oh, yeah. Once. I had half an hour. I needed it. Hey, isn't that wonky Warner? Allowed out without a leash, are you, wonk? Hey, wonk. Given any blood lately? Oops. Oh. Hope I didn't hurt it.
What's going on here? Oh, I've been keeping an eye on things. I think I should break that up.
Anderson, break it up! Stop that! Stop it!
Who started this?
Just having a bit of fun, that's all.
Yeah, a friendly wrestle. No harm done.
Come with me, Lynn. Your father's here. He's with Mrs. Davidson at the moment. Now, I suggest you go and tidy up.
She can't seem to stay out of trouble, can she?
You better watch you don't go too far, Anderson.
All I did was accidentally stand on one of her veggies. You saw it, didn't you?
Yeah, I saw it.
Lunch already, is it? Well, how's the rest of the world getting on without me?
We'll survive.
Any chance of a book?
You're getting lonely, Davidson.
I sure am.
That's the idea.
Bastard.
Hello, Lynn.
Dad. Would you like to sit down? So, how have you been?
I'm all right.
Is Mum okay?
She's in hospital.
What?
You heard.
In hospital? Why?
I would have thought that'd be obvious.
Well, tell me what's wrong with her.
She took a bit of a turn after she heard what you'd done. It was on the television and the radio and the whole town knew about it.
Oh, is she going to be all right?
We don't know.
Well, why didn't you write and tell me?
I couldn't see the point.
How can you say that? She's my mother.
That's never mattered to you before. What we feel and what we think hasn't meant a damn thing to you. You just went on your way, getting into one fix after another, each one worse than before, doing what you want to do, not thinking of anyone else. Well, your mother can't take any more. Neither can I.
Look, excuse me, Mr. Warner, I don't think
Do you mind? It's bad enough having eavesdropping in the same room without butting into something that's not your business. I think I know what I'm talking about. She's my daughter, not yours.
I'm sorry.
If I haven't been to see you before, it's because of the farm. It won't run itself, you know. I can't just up and come to the city every time you get yourself into trouble. I'm staying with your Aunt Dorian and Uncle George. It's bad enough having to face them. Tell me, what am I meant to do with you, eh? Just tell me.
This rubbish on the wall.
Got to do something.
Someone's
got
to clean it off. Give it to me. Come on.
How else can I stop from going out of my mind? You don't know what it's like. No one to talk to, nothing to do.
You climbed down a bit since I last saw you, haven't you? Must be doing you good.
How much longer do I have to stay in here?
Oh, it's up to the VJ. It's a nice day outside.
What's a VJ?
Visiting Justice. He could put you back in here for another week.
What?
If you're lucky, that is. You could score a fortnight if he calls in a second opinion and they both think that what you did is serious enough. And I do. You're going to run out of walls, aren't you, Davidson?
I'm not staying in here.
You've got no choice. Mind you, you could call witnesses in your defense. But I wouldn't advise it.
Why not?
Because there aren't any witnesses, are there?
I can think of one.
You've already crossed me once, Davidson. I wouldn't try it again. Best for you to accept your punishment and try and stay out of trouble in the future. That's my advice. Oh, and I wouldn't think about appealing to your aunt for help. She probably won't be here.
Where's she going?
The governor's movements are none of the prisoner's business.
Hey, they told me you want a word with me about my daughter.
That's right, Mr. Warner. Won't you come in? I thought it might be a good idea.
Has she got herself a lawyer?
Yes, you've no need to worry about that.
Who's paying for her?
Legal aid.
Oh. What are her chances?
Well, that's hard to say at the moment, but I'm sure Mr. Wilson will do the best he can for her.
Who's Wilson?
Stephen Wilson, that's her lawyer.
Oh, I see.
Won't you sit down? I know it must be difficult for you being here.
Oh, you're damn right. Sorry, excuse me.
There's no need to apologize. I understand how you must be feeling.
Do you? How? Have you ever had a daughter in a mess like this?
Of course not.
And you don't know, do you?
We're concerned for her, that's all.
And I'm not. Is that the idea?
I didn't say that.
Oh, I know. You young, educated people, you think that we're old, we're not too sophisticated. Farmers are meant to be stupid because they don't read books half their life to find out what they want to be. Well, I can catch the drift as fast as the next one. You don't need a university degree. And ever since I set foot in this place, people are telling me what I didn't do, what I should have done, and what a bloody awful parent I've been.
Mr. Warner, I'm sure...
No, let me finish. You think I've let my daughter down? Oh, you all think that here. You think I've been hard. You think I've turned my back. Well, let me tell you something. My wife and I have worked hard all our lives. I'm not blowing my trumpet. That's just a fact. We've worked hard to provide a good home and bring our daughter up the right way, to give her a good start in life. Sure, what's right? What's wrong? At least that's what we thought. We didn't want her running away to the city like that. That was her idea. Her mother told her she'd be sorry. And then when she came back, with that business of the kiddie, you know, we were willing to forgive and forget and start all over again. And then what does she do? She shoots through with that no-hoper, that Doug Parker. I saw through him in 5 minutes. You couldn't tell her, though. And now look what's happened. Honest. God, you get to the stage, you wonder if you've ever done anything right.
I do understand how you must be feeling, Mr. Warner. But what happens now?
Well, I'm not going to give up on her, if that's what you expect me to say. Not yet, anyway. God knows why.
Lynn is a very naive girl, and she's easily influenced by stronger personalities if she thinks that they'll accept her. I think that might have been the case with Doug Parker. What I'm trying to say is that she's not strong enough yet, particularly after what happened to her recently, to stand on her own. That'll take time. Right now, she needs to know that someone's going to accept her, in spite of everything. Somebody who won't give up on her. She needs her parents.
Of course she needs her parents. I know that. What have I been saying? But you try and tell her that.
I'm sure you'll be able to manage without me just this once.
Your niece is appearing before the VJ.
I know. That doesn't make any difference. I'm not here to provide special privileges for her. She's just another prisoner. I thought I'd made that quite clear.
I think we can handle it.
I don't see why not. It's just a routine matter. Bring Lizzie Birdsworth to the reception area, would you please, Mrs. Jackson? Give my regards to the VJ. Oh, and ask him whatever happened to Mr. Bell. He may know. We haven't seen him for ages.
Bye, Mrs. Davidson.
Yes, Lynn. Did you see my father, Miss Vernon?
Yes, I did.
And what did he say about me?
Well, he wanted to know what your chances were and if I'd found your lawyer.
What did he say?
Lynn, what do you want from your parents?
What?
What do you expect them to be?
I just want them to try and understand.
Is that all?
I don't want them to hate me.
They don't hate you, Lynn.
Oh, he was so angry. I've never seen him like that before. He blames me for everything.
He's upset because of your mother and how everything seems to have gone sour. But he wants to help you. He told me so.
Only because that's what you expected. You were wrong before. He came to see me because he felt he had to, not because he wanted to. I could feel it.
Then why did you ask me what he said about you?
I had to be sure.
Lynn, you haven't been listening to what I've said.
I remember what you said this morning about trying to feel sorry for him instead of myself. Well, I tried and he just wouldn't listen. And if that's the way he feels...
Lynn!
At 2:30, don't forget. Be there on time.
What was that all about?
Nothing important. How did Lynn Warner get on with her visitor?
I didn't know you were interested in Lynn, Vera.
It was her father, wasn't it? I bet he tore strips off of the silly little fool.
Yes, he did. Hardly the best thing at the moment.
Why not? She deserves it.
Oh, come off it, Vera. You know what I'm talking about.
Afraid she'll do herself in.
She tried once.
Rubbish. She wasn't trying to kill herself. She's not the type.
Well, what is the type?
She's just looking for attention, trying to create as much fuss as she can.
There are easier ways of gaining attention.
But nothing so effective as a suicide attempt.
You don't honestly believe that.
If you had any sense, you would too.
She could have died.
But she didn't. She knows what she's doing. Make you too soft-hearted. She's got you wrapped round her little finger.
Now, that's not true. But someone's got to keep an eye on her. You can't ignore what's happened in the past.
Then think about all the trouble you had getting her case reopened. And what did she do? Back like a revolving door. You're wasting your time.
Where are you off to, Anderson?
The garden. It's crying out for my green fingers.
There's work to be done in the laundry.
Don't worry, Mrs. Jackson. It's all under control.
She's the one you should be watching.
Don't worry. I am watching.
What are you doing, Monk?
What does it look like?
Tough, eh?
Tough as custard.
Who asked you?
Listen, if you've got anything smart to say, you can buzz off, Doreen. I haven't forgotten what you said before.
I was just joking. No need to get shirty.
What do you want, Doreen?
Why aren't you doing your little garden? We thought we might give you a hand.
Like last time.
Oh, yeah, but I've been reading up on it since then. I don't reckon I'll make the same mistakes as I did the last time.
Yeah, I grew a pot plant once.
You can do what you like, I don't care.
Don't you?
No, I've just about had a belly full. I'm not doing anything anymore for anyone, just for myself.
Is that so?
I just told you, didn't I?
Seems to me you're waking up to a few things.
Yeah, maybe I am.
And from what I hear, you're not too innocent this time, eh?
No.
Well, then you're one of us now, aren't you?
Yes.
Oh. Hey, it's a buy-up this afternoon.
You got any money?
No.
You? Well, what are you getting all excited about?
Just remembered, that's all.
Yeah.
Suppose we've got to miss out.
Frankie never went short of a smoke.
That was Frankie.
No reason why we should either.
What do you mean?
I know how she used to work it.
Yeah? You reckon we could too? Of
course we could. Yeah?
What are you talking about?
None of your business. Look, what do you think you're doing?
Just sitting.
Look, Wonk, what do you want?
Nothing. I can sit here if I want to.
It's not a bloody Tupperware party.
Maybe she'd like to help us, Doreen.
Her? Don't make me laugh.
What have you got to do?
Nothing that you'd be any good at.
You said I was one of you, remember?
We could do with some extra help.
All right, we'll give you a go. Seeing's how you're turning over a new leaf.
What have I got to do?
Ah, Mr. Godwin.
Mrs. Jackson, how are you?
Oh, we didn't know who to expect today. Mr. Bell still away?
Yes, he's in England visiting his daughter. I don't know how he finds the time. My hands are full just keeping up with my work. Actually, I'm a little surprised to see you still here. Well, I heard about your husband. That was a terrible thing. These women need a firmer hand. How's Mrs. Davidson?
Oh, Mrs. Davidson isn't here today, Mr. Goodwin. She has business outside the prison. Miss Bennett is in charge.
Is she now? Fine woman, Miss Bennett. Very efficient. Well, we mustn't keep her waiting. Shall we go?
Certainly. She's in Mrs. Davidson's office.
Thank you, Dwyer. You may go.
Would you like me to send the first girl in, Miss Bennett?
No hurry, Meg. Mr. Goodwin and I will have tea first. I'll call you when we're ready for the first case. Barbara Davidson.
Whatever you say.
Thank you, Meg. Oh, let reception know where you are so that I can find you. Now, how do you like your tea, Mr. Goodwin?
Black with no sugar, thank you. May I say what a pleasant surprise it is to see you sitting in that chair?
It's only while Mrs. Davidson's away, of course. But very nice of you to say so.
Well, not at all. I've often felt the authorities weren't making good enough use of your ability.
Unfortunately, too few people feel that way. Vanilla slice?
Thank you.
That's great, Mum. How's the flat going? Terrific. Yeah, well, I'll see you soon. Bye. That was Mum. She and Judith Ann are getting along famously. Everything's fine.
Oh, that's good.
I think I only rang her to reassure myself that I can do something all right.
Oh, come on. What do you mean?
Oh, you should have been a fly on the wall when Lynn Warner's father came to see me. I mean, talk about a disaster. And Lynn, too. I thought I was making myself perfectly clear, making good sense.
Well, some people only hear what they want to hear.
Yeah. But it's my job to get a foothold in there somewhere.
Well, I'll tell you something that'll make your day. You should see Vera in the governor's office. She's all set up with an enormous tray of tea and cakes. And she's entertaining the VJ as though she were holding a garden party in Government House.
Oh, it doesn't surprise me.
Eric has only gone for the afternoon, and Vera's carrying on as though she were founding a dynasty.
Yeah, the thousand-year Reich. Heil Vera. You know, your Miss Bennett only makes my job more difficult. I've got to undo all her good work in making those women feel worthless and crushing whatever hope they have in bettering themselves. God help us if she's any more than governor for a day. Jean Vernon. The Führer.
Yes, Vera. Right. Right, I'll bring her up straight away. She's ready for Davidson. Well, between the two of them, I think our little Barbara's in for a tough time.
Hmm.
Prattler.
Thanks, real generous of you.
Give them back.
You keep your mouth shut if you want to stay healthy, all right? Give them back, you bastard.
Hold up. Let me go.
Screws.
Who's doing all that yelling?
Yelling? We didn't hear any yelling, did we, girls?
No. You all right, Lynn?
Yeah, why shouldn't I be?
Everybody else get back to work. It's been enough loitering for one day.
Oh, because of you, we lost them smokes.
Yeah.
You piss weak. Bloody useless.
Davidson, time for you to see the VJ. He hasn't got all day. Now move along. Now, this is an informal hearing. You have the right to call witnesses and cross-examine them if you wish. The name of the justice is Mr. Goodwin. That is how you will address him. Any questions?
Everyone seems to have made up their minds about me. Big, bad Barbara.
Don't flatter yourself.
Well, I've got news for you. The staff here aren't so lily-white.
What do you mean?
There's a certain officer who was only too willing to help me get stuff into this place.
Who?
If you don't mind, I think I'll keep it for Mr. Goodwin.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines. The sun and rain are prisoners too. When morning comes around, last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known. Till I had to face the nightmare. The roses heal.